गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, हार्टली वेलकम।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
हार्टली वेलकम टू द प्रिंसिपल्स एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू द फोर्थ डे, द पेनल्टीमेट डे ऑफ द 5-डे वर्कशॉप on competency based learning. Today we are going to have the fourth theme, problem based learning. For that we are fortunate enough to have a very experienced person with us, Dr. Aloka Kanhare. She is from Homi Baba Center, HBCSC, Mumbai. She got her MSc from IIT Bombay and PhD from Homi Baba National Institute, and she is the project scientific officer and involved in managing the Vigyan Pratibha project. She was a regional coordinator of Ekalaiva, coordinated the Shahpur component program for developing models for quality education for children and teachers in two tribal blocks of Madhya Pradesh. She is having a lot of teaching experience with her school teaching course, Introduction to Science Mathematics Education Research, Pedagogy of Mathematics, and Introduction to Mathematics Education to name a few. And our outreach programs are Story of Pi at MTS program, HBCSC Mumbai, Add Your Boon, Subtract Your Course, Max in Stories at Chai and Y in Mumbai. She is involved in several projects, both projects with government and also project with agencies. And government projects, to name a few, is a part of the committee for developing curriculum of the B.Ed. course for the state of Chhattisgarh in 2015. She was a part of the committee for curriculum material writing for D.Ed. course for the state of Rajasthan. She was a part of the committee for curriculum restructuring for the state of Maharashtra. And she was a part of research study entitled Achievement Survey at the End of Class 3, a Ministry of Human Resource Development project, different proficiency levels, basic, proficient, an advanced level of cognitive processes were identified at this project. And she is having a technical session. She has taken a lot of technical session. I had a interaction with her also in Vidya Pradiman program, and she is a very talented and highly experienced scholar, and she is having a lot of publication to her credit also. On behalf of the director, Zonal Institute of Education and Training, Mumbai, and all the principals and participants of this workshop, a warm welcome to Dr. Aloka. Aloka madam, we are having 50 participants from 25 regions. They are going to act as master trainers. They are going to take this program forward by training the teachers in their regions. Not only that, we, for the first time, we are having the principals from the region who will act as the course directors also. Therefore, we are having the person who are going to be involved in the program with us. Therefore, I welcome to you once again, madam. Over to Dr. Aloka.
Thank you, Srinivas ji. Am I audible?
Yes, madam, you are audible. Yeah. Please continue.
Yeah. So, good morning to all of you. I think we'll start with the session. And then at the end of the session, I will talk to you about the group work. Is it my mic which is creating this? So at the end of the group, session, I will actually talk about the group work, and you can have your questions for it. So I'll just straight go to the session and I'll start. And please feel free to send your answers in the chat, or even unmute and talk. I would like this to be an interactive session where you answer. I mean, we solve problems together, because it's a problem based learning course, so we cannot do without solving problems, right? Isn't it? We'll have to solve problems. So you can nod, because I can see some of your cameras on. So do you agree with me that for a problem solving course, we need a problem based learning thing? We have to solve problems.
Definitely.
Yeah. Okay, so so what we are going to do is we are going to look at some problems, and we'll solve it and we'll talk about it. So I'm going to go straight to the I'm going to start sharing. And please feel free to send your messages in the chat box whenever you want to. Can it be, is it visible? No, not yet.
Yes, madam, continue, yes, it's visible now. We'll continue with the presentation.
Okay, fine. So, why do we ask problems in the class? I mean, like, why do we, when we go to the classroom and ask problems to our children, students, why do we ask problems? Like, what is the intention with which we ask those problems?
To provide a stimulus for thinking.
To provide a stimulus for thinking, yeah.
Attention of the students towards the teaching.
Attention of the students towards the teaching, yeah.
Creating excitement for the topic.
Creating excitement for the topic, okay. One of the things that I, when I started teaching, one of the things that I started doing was why I asked problems or sums or what problems in the class was for assessment, to just check whether whatever I'm saying they have understanding or not, they're liking it or not. So assessment of different kinds. And then also to check if the concept is understood. So they know it or not, and then they understand it or not. They are two different things. People agree with me, right? Knowing and understanding are different things at times, especially with children, right? Okay, so, as all of you in your answers also said, that problems can also be scenes or scenarios or situations of learning, right? Children can learn while solving problems. You agree with me that solving a problem also teaches, yeah, right. Yes, Manisha ma'am. So whether they understand or not, right? So you agree with me that problems itself can be a situation of learning.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Yes.
You agree with me, you know. So what kind of, like, you agree with me that the problems can help students in learning. So, but what are these kind of problems that help students in learning? Okay, so we are going to look at some problems which I think create a scenario or a situation of learning for children. We'll also discuss why we think that can be a situation for learning, and then go ahead. Okay. Yeah, fine. So look at this problem. A polar bear weighs 500 kgs. How many children do you need to have the same weight? So what do you take from this problem? Like, what is your first impression of this problem? The first impression that you get when you see this problem.
Some more data required.
Who said that?
Myself,
Srinivasan. It's a insufficient data. That's what Purushottam sir says. Yeah, right. It's insufficient. What else?
It is a question of estimation.
Who said that?
I'm here, ma'am. Vivek Nathani.
Yeah, Vivek sir says it's a question of estimation. Okay, Vivek sir says that. Dinesh sir also says that. Yeah, so it's very interesting. So This is a one question, it's a polar bear question, it's a very polarizing question, because there are a lot of teachers who say that this is insufficient data, because you haven't told us what is the weight of every child. So how can we tell you what it is thing is, right? But as some of you, like Dinesh sir said and Vivek sir said, estimation. So this problem was, when it's given to children, and it has actually been given to children, and there's a lot of data about this problem, and it's very interesting. So there was this one child who was given this problem, and what he did was went and asked their weight to each and every classmate of his, noted it down, totaled it, and then whatever was remaining said, oh, there's a young baby of that weight, and got that weight. This is a sense of a sense of estimation. It is also in some sense a data collection, right? So you are actually, without telling the child is figuring out a way to figure out the 500 kgs. There's another child who was 24 kgs and said, okay, if I'm 25, then multiplied by 20, and then said, okay, so 20 children like me. So a problem like this, which some of us felt was insufficient information, and some of us felt was an estimation problem, is actually a lot of other things, right? It's data collection, it is estimation, it's multiplication, it is a lot of things. You agree with me? You can also chat if you,
yes.
you want to. Yeah. So this is a very interesting. Yeah, this is a very interesting problem, and this has actually like across every time I show this to teachers, there are a lot of teachers who say it's insufficient information. And I think the first time when I saw it, I also thought that like how will a child solve this? I don't know how many children will need because I don't know the weight of the child. So. But it's children solve it. And actually, I don't know any child who has said this is insufficient data. So, anyways, I'll go ahead. Okay. So now this you'll have to solve this and either put it in chat or tell me the answers for the first one. So what can be the answers for the first one? So first blank and second blank. So this is a sum given to by a teacher to a student, and then there's ink spilt on the homework. So the child doesn't know what to do. So can you help the child? Or this problem cannot be solved.
We cannot write any number. We can write any number and we can solve it.
I'm asking. Do you think this can be solved?
Yeah. We can write any number and
this
solve.
Can be solved. This can be solved by writing any number 207 plus 60.
Child will consider 27 and 6, 10 and 5.
No, not consider 27 because there is a space. We can write 207 plus 60. Yes. 207 plus 60.
You have to find the answer also.
We can write any number.
Insufficient data. Insufficient data.
Who said that?
Surendra Prasad.
Okay.
Insufficient data. Answer of the student will different.
Yeah. It's not a problem. Every child can get a different answer.
That's Bindu ma'am.
Answer will be different.
Answer is different. That's correct. But is there a problem if that is?
It's not a problem. Every child can have his own. Yeah.
Madam, it has many solutions. It will be a problem.
If it has many solutions, it's a problem. Why?
For any equation, you have some number of
insufficient data.
Insufficient? For every child, the answer is correct, and teacher can actually see it for every child. The answer is correct because he puts the value, yes. So it will be correct for him.
This is a
mathematical problem.
They can do it. We have to check that each child has done it correctly or not. That's all.
Yeah, that's all. We have the numbers, so we can check it. Correct, ma'am. I feel like that.
Ma'am. Yeah. सबसे पहले बच्चा एक क्वेश्चन देखेगा तो वो कंफ्यूज हो जाएगा. वो बोलेगा क्या है इसमें, क्या करना है, वो ये सोचते रह जाएगा.
अच्छा, मैंने ये दिया है सर. एक्चुअली गुरु सर स्पोक इन हिंदी, सो आई स्पोक इन हिंदी, बट आई एम सॉरी. सो इज देयर एनीबॉडी इन द ग्रुप हु इज नॉट कंफर्टेबल विद हिंदी? नो. ओके, फाइन. सो एनीवे, सो गुरु सर, एक्चुअली दिस डजंट हैपन. द सेम थिंग एज द 500 केजीज, द चिल्ड्रन एक्चुअली डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. They say, okay, this is the number. And this is the way you solve it. As Bindu ma'am or another ma'am also said that they think that there will be about, it will be 227 and 62 and give you the answer. The point is not, it's not that it's, so you are telling them to add. They're adding the way you want them to add. But they're also doing some more of their own work, right? Also, there's no carrying over. So they know that, for example, if we go to the, like, we see the problem, we see that there might not be, the children actually figure out that there is, like, this, when I gave this problem to a child and I asked him, can there be a 5? Can it be 65 in the first problem? And he said, no, because there is no carryover one. So the children by themselves actually figured out that there should not be a carryover because that is not, that cannot be here in the solving. So, I mean, there are other people who had carryovers, but this whole idea that it, because there is no carryover, so it has to be less than 3 is mathematics, right? You agree with me, no?
No, no need to carry on, ma'am, because it is not a solved problem. It is only a problem given and the ink spill on the.
Yeah, exactly. But so, the child.
If it is an answered problem, then you will have a carryover.
तो जब टारगेट नहीं है तो वो निकालेगा कैसे, वो कंफ्यूज हो जाएगा.
नहीं होते हैं
Actually, sometimes students did mistake. No, we used to write and cut. He may think he wrote something, he cut and again write another number. So he may consider as a 27 only. In that way, also he can solve.
No, no. But the question you are asking that the ink is covering a digit. That's the question.
Okay.
Yeah. The question is that the ink is covering the digit. What, like, how can you solve it? Then how can you help him? So this is actually.
This is a pure example of problem based learning.
Yeah, exactly. This is an example of problem based learning. Okay. So do I go ahead? Yeah. Okay. Now this is the problem. Do you want me to read the problem aloud, or is it okay? So Meenu and Saira are traveling to Pune from their home in Mumbai. There was a milestone they saw when the bus was starting. So the milestone says 170 kilometers. Another half an hour later, they saw this milestone, which said 150 kilometers. After an hour, another milestone passed, but the distance written on it had faded because of dust and heat. It was not visible at all. Could you try to estimate what the number it must have been? After 60 kilometers, another milestone appeared. On this, the number was also not visible. How far do you think Pune is now? Is this also insufficient data?
No, it is 110 no. and 50. 110 and 50.
Actually, this can be done. It will depend on the first, second case. Whatever the child takes the distance after 1 hour, on the basis of that, other can be calculated. So it's up to him whether whatever he writes in front of 150, depending upon that, he can calculate the other data.
150 is visible.
Some number should be there before, I think, before that.
No, it's 170 and then 150. No, they're closing towards Pune, no?
Okay, they're going towards Pune. Okay, then it can be done.
Yeah, it is after 1 hour means you must have traveled 40 kilometers. We take the average speed of here, 40 kilometers, so it will be 110. And almost one is seen here. Then after 60 kilometers, minus 60, 50. So 110 and 50. Okay.
Yeah, so what do you think? Is this a place to where you can pick up your is this a problem where you learn, and what do you learn?
A lot of very good problem it's
What do you learn from this?
Calculation of speed also, estimation same speed distance, can also distance right. That particular can be learned.
The concept of uniform speed.
Yeah.
Uniform speed.
Distance, speed, and distance.
Okay, so I had given this problem and exactly like what you are saying, that I had given this with the point of view that it is average speed and it's just numbers. So like, you know, half an hour 20, so full 1 hour 40, and then like so whatever after 60, so you get you subtract the 60 from the 110. When I gave this problem to this was when I was in Madhya Pradesh and middle school children, when I gave this problem to them, one of them actually said that it is never the case that a bus actually goes at average speed, because bus stops in between. If you give me at the end of what the child said was that aakhri mein bataoge to main average kar dunga, so like if you tell me the entire time taken and the distance, I can tell you the average, but how can I assume that it will be average at every minute? But that's what you're assuming right now, right? Isn't it?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes.
Right.
and then actually and then the classroom went into a completely different interaction where the children also estimated if what if the bus would have stopped in between in that 60 kilometers. So like what would have happened with the time, what if it was the ghats. So it was actually a very interesting conversation we had where we actually talked about very different kinds of numbers and relationship of numbers and not just stopped at average, which was not my intention when I went and to give this class. When I gave this, it was just addition and finding average and figuring and coming to the idea of average without saying that. Am I clear in what I said?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
It's interesting, right? What the child said. It never occurred to us that actually buses never move at average speed, but we all of us assumed that it was average speed, right? Yeah. So, But Sumit sir, you're saying that assumption is bus is moving at uniform speed, but you're actually using the bus here. So it cannot be that the assumption will be true. Am I correct, Sumit sir?
But ma'am, excuse me, ma'am. When we are solving mathematical problems, we take ideal conditions. Otherwise, anything can happen. Some problem or something happens in between, accident happens in between or anything can happen.
Yeah.
But we cannot predict. When we are doing mathematics, we do not consider all these things. Otherwise, we will not be able to solve any problem anytime.
No, I'm saying that somebody if a child wants to take ideal conditions and solve. Hey, Vivek sir, I understood your point. What I'm saying is that if a child wants to accept average speed, I'm not saying it's wrong. I'm saying, but if some child is questioning it, what is wrong in that?
No, that is okay, but we cannot we cannot just go beyond the flights of imagination of every child in a class. There are 40 students will think in 40 ways. Someone will say that this milestone was wrong.
But then otherwise you cannot have, you'll have to have some space for these things. Some space you will have to give, no?
We will have to give critical thinking is okay, but
this is critical thinking.
But just following the flights of imagination, I do not think that.
But sir, but then I can also tell you that I never told you that the bus is traveling at average speed. You assume that, and in mathematics, that is not allowed. You cannot decide your own assumptions.
Yes, we cannot decide our assumptions, but we have to follow the ideal conditions while.
But I did not tell you that it was moving at an average speed.
So then again, we have to say it is insufficient.
These are all open questions.
Then it is there in the bus. Let's move on. Assuming that the bus is traveling at uniform speed, all those things come in between. Keep it. While teaching, sometimes we skip it because we go in the natural way, it has to be calculated this way. But that is not the way. In the real life, how it has to come.
In the real life, there is nothing like average speed or uniform speed.
Vivek sir, please let me tell you that in real life, there is average speed. The point is that the bus doesn't move at average speed. There are different things.
Real life, there is nothing like uniform speed on roads.
Yes, there is nothing like that, but I think we should move ahead. Okay, so the next problem, this is a very standard problem. Nobody will have problems with the insufficient data of this that we ask in classroom. This is another problem, and I want you to basically look at these two problems and find the difference between them, the similarity between them. And if there's nothing, you can say that there is no similarity between them or no difference between them. This is it my mic or somebody else's mic, which is there's a lot of disturbance.
Madam, you are logged in with two. Madam, you are logged with I think two.
No,
your presentation.
I'm muted there. Sir, I'm completely muted there.
Presentation is not muted, madam.
I'm muted there, sir.
Even then, the disturbance will be there.
No, but it's far away. I don't think it's that.
Madam, you continue, madam. I have muted one or two.
Yeah, okay. So, can you see the problems?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, so what is there any similarity between these two or difference between these two? Or if there is nothing, then you say there is nothing. There is no similarity, no difference. But like, look at these two and see whether can you do any comparison of these two?
They're similar questions.
They're similar. In what way are they similar?
Two is being each. There are two. It is two, and each is being divided into half.
And
the first problem.
Different.
First problem. Two is being divided into half parts. Yeah. So it becomes four. The second one, again, you have two loaves of bread. So you are dividing each part into half. So four.
Right. I'm dividing each into half, right? But it's not two divided by half, is it?
No. It is two parts divided into half.
Excuse me, madam. Yeah. What I feel that first is division, but second one is repeated subtraction. Means it is subtraction one by two from two, again it is subtraction, again it is subtraction. It is four times subtraction. The second right. problem is problem of subtraction.
And the first is not?
First is simply division is there. Anna.
Okay.
But second is repeatedly same 1/2 subtraction from two.
But sir, don't we say repeated subtraction is division?
They can
yes, ma'am, that is true that repetitive subtraction is division. But in the first question, it is straightforward, like two is divided into parts of half. So it is basically division. In second one, according to the question, it has to go like by repetitive subtraction.
Acha, okay. Anybody else wants to add to what?
Excuse me, madam.
Literally, it interprets half a loaf. Literally, it interprets half a loaf. Not half of the bread she has. That means not a repeated subtraction. It is equal to first question, that was I feel.
Ma'am, the first question.
Ma'am.
In the first question, we will directly solve. And in the second question, children can opt any of the method and solve the question.
Yeah, right.
Ma'am,
the child is free to opt any method and solve. It can be either repeated or it can be by division or any method.
Ma'am, this first question can be solved by children mechanically without understanding.
I think let's all mute ourselves for a minute because I think there's a lot of chaos. So let's all mute ourselves.
Please give a chance for others to please.
Hello, ma'am. In first case, when we are dividing two by half.
Please mute yourself. Bindu, please, all of us mute ourselves. Let's all mute ourselves for a minute, for a second. Please just mute ourselves. It's a lot of chaos, and I mean.
Bindu madam, please stop your presentation. Bindu, please stop your presentation.
I don't know why. Okay, fine. So, there is some. Why is somebody presenting apart from me?
Sudhanshu sir, presenting band kijiye.
Hey, Bindu madam is presenting.
Aloka, your presentation started. No problem.
Yes, ma'am. Hello.
Yeah.
In this particular question, when we are dividing two by half, we are getting four, and all those four parts are of uniform size or uniform quantity. But when we are dividing the second question, when we are dividing two loops, then those two loops may not be of same size. That means the part, even though we are getting four dogs, we are giving it to four dogs, but the share each dog is getting may not be equal. Because
so it says half a loaf.
Yes, ma'am, but two loops may not be of same size. That means although we are giving it to four dogs, but the part each dog is getting may not be the same.
Acha, so you're basically saying that she might not be able to break it into like exactly half. That's the problem.
Yes, ma'am. Those two loaves may be of different size.
Yeah, fine. What I'm saying is that there were other some people who said that these are the same question. The answer is the same. But are the questions the same? Is my question.
May I respond? Ma'am, in the first question, we are directing.
No. Sir, please. Sir, 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 please, who is this? Who is this? Vivek sir. Vivek sir, let's give other people a chance.
Y.K. Rana speaking, ma'am.
Yeah.
Dehradun. Ma'am, second question, doesn't it depend on the number of stray dogs she sees? Suppose if there is no dogs, no stray dogs there are, then I don't think the question will proceed further.
Nice one. Yeah, that's possible.
Ma'am, according to me, ma'am, in the first question, child has to adopt a single method to solve the question. In the second question, child can adopt, let us miss any type of methods he or she can adopt to solve the question. If a child is of higher class, he can directly do the division and solve. And if he belongs to a smaller class, then he can just simply subtract it and do it. Or by any other means also, he can do it. Yeah, so this is only my opinion, what I mean to say.
Roli ma'am, right? Yeah, thank you very much. See, the thing is that, yes, but... No, sir, Guru. Guru sir, let me first talk, and then you can... let me complete, sir, and you can talk, So, you're right. I mean, we're talking about solving problems, but I'm also talking about whether this is a situation of learning. Is this a place where a child is learning something new? Right? And so my question to you is that in the second one, all of you said that it is repeated subtraction, it is A. But isn't it also a meaning of division? How many halves in two is what exactly two divided by half means? Am I correct? Should I repeat myself?
Yes, madam. Madam, first one is a mathematical concept that we teach to the class children. And second one is the application of this concept. The real life situation where the child can apply this concept.
But Sarvishtha ma'am, isn't the second question also a way to actually find out that meaning of division?
No madam, actually I wanted to mean that 2 divided by half is 4. The child learns directly. Now whenever she or he is coming across a situation when two objects are there and the child has to divide it into halves, then directly without going for subtracting repeatedly, the child can use that concept because concepts are given just for the application to the real life situation.
You're saying 2 divided by half is equal to 4 is not a concept. 2 divided by half is equal to 4 is just a formula.
It's a process, madam. Division, what we teach for the rational numbers and the real numbers.
It's a formula you're telling them. It's a technique you're telling them ki 2 divided by half is always 4, right? But why is it why is 2 divided by half 4? Anyways, I'll come back to Sarvishtha ma'am. Why is 2 divided by half 4?
For the concept of subtraction.
Division principle.
What is the division principle?
Madam, when we are dividing, we are taking the division, we convert as into and the reciprocal of the second number we will take and to do.
Why do we do that?
Because division is the opposite sign of multiplication. So division is there, so we are converting into multiplication, then
it's not exactly opposite. You multiply by the multiplicative inverse, right?
Multiplicative inverse, yes.
Right. So that's what you do. That's why. But that's what I'm saying. So this is what you are saying is you're just giving me a technique. How do I do? See, but 2 divided by half. Yes.
2 means there are 2 things. 2 means there are 2 things and you're dividing each thing into half. So you get 4. 4 things.
Ma'am, with the help of fractions, can we?
With the help of fractions as in?
Fraction. Concept of the fraction.
Right. So I'm saying, but this is not just fraction. For example, 4 divided, it is also the meaning of division. Yeah. And give me just a minute to say this line again. And then we can actually go and check out this meaning of division. And that is exactly why I wanted to give these 2 problems. So
multiplicative inverse.
No, it's not just multiplicative inverse, Surendra sir. It is also how much of, like, so 2 divided by half is how much of half, how many halves fit inside 2? Is that okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. How many halves are there?
How many halves are in inside 2? That is 2 divided by half. And that is also in true with integers. So 4 divided by 2, 4 like 6 divided by 2 is 3, because how many 2s sits inside 6? 6. 6 divided by 2 is 3, so how many 2s fit inside 6?
And that is fraction only, no madam?
Yeah, it is fraction, yes, I agree. But it's division. I mean, understanding the meaning of division, isn't it? Is it correct?
Few fractions we can explain division slightly clearly.
Yeah, exactly. This meaning of division can be clear. But that's why this problem. So the second problem versus the first problem, the second problem actually tells you the definition of the meaning of division, right? Instead of the first problem, which is just a technique. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, very okay, very much okay, madam. Right.
Yeah, fine. So I'll move ahead, huh? Okay, so now I want you to you must be sitting with a pen and a paper. So I want you to just roughly talk about how to construct an angle of 30 degrees. Just one of you, unmute. You can type in the chat saying I am unmuting and then chat, my unmute. Yes, Sumit, so you are correct. It's a little bit subtraction.
Madam, can I answer this question? You take any that is equilateral triangle, madam, equilateral triangle, and fold all the three sides that you will get in between. Angle bisect only. You can show at 30 degrees.
Okay, I'm sorry. I should have said straight edge and compass. I'm sorry, my mistake. So how do you construct the angle of measuring 30 degrees using a straight edge and compass?
Bisecting 60 degrees. So
can use instruments.
Huh?
Make 60 and bisect.
Bisecting 60 degrees.
And bisect the 60 degrees.
Okay. Sudhanshu sir, sorry, not Sudhanshu sir. RP Sinha sir, I'm sorry. I just saw the name and I said it. Okay. Yeah, so you bisect 60 degrees. And how do you get 60 degrees?
With help of compass.
How do you draw 60 degrees?
From the starting point, you draw one moment and equal arc you can cut and join, you will get the 60 degrees. Protractor, you can do no madam.
How? I'm asking you the question. How did you get?
Draw a ray. So from starting point you cut an arc with the same length, you can cut where the arc cut from that point to another arc. That point to initial point you join, you will get the 60 degrees. If you fold automatically, it will come 30.
So Sumit sir is saying by drawing an equilateral triangle we'll get 60 degrees. Correct. Absolutely. I will not go into right, that's the concept. So, and then you draw angle bisector. How do you draw angle bisector?
Draw an angle. So, with any radius, cut. With any radius, cut an arc. It will cut the angle, rays into two points. One point has center, one arc, another point has center, another arc. So, both will intersect at a point from what common vertex to that point.
Same length or different length arc?
All the four have to be the same length.
No, my question is all the four have to be the same length or different length is okay?
So different length also okay, no problem.
Different length also, no problem.
Depend upon the situation, that problem.
Okay. Now how are you sure that after you do this construction that the angle is 30 degrees?
Because the two arcs that you'll be drawing will be of same length. So using the principle of congruence, that particular line will divide it into two equal parts. The two sides, the two arcs you're taking is equal actually. So the properties of triangles, we can say that it will divide it into two equal parts.
Right. So is it clear what madam said?
Yes, madam.
Otherwise, at the end of it, I can actually do a GeoGebra file and show you if you want. But what I was saying is that, so if I stop, at asking you to construct an angle at 30 degrees, one doesn't really. Yeah? If I ask the next two questions around it, do you think that enriches the question of construction?
Yes, of course, madam. And in class 9th, when we are starting this construction, it is given in the textbook also. All these concepts are given before the construction.
Right. So that you are, you basically, every time you ask a construction, you actually ask the children to think about how do they verify it, and then how do they actually see it always works. So like, for example, one of the, your teacher, I think Sumit sir, said that you'll fold it and see. And that's true. You can fold it and see. But then how do you know that every time you fold it, it will be 30 degrees, right? So that's why whatever Bindu ma'am said, that actually makes more sense, that you actually come up with a geometric argument about it, right? Okay. Now this is my personal favorite. I really like this problem. So the problem is, there's a swimming pool to be tiled using 1 square unit tiles like shown above. How many tiles would you need if that swimming pool is now 10 cross 10? So this is, you can see there's a 1 cross 1, a 2 cross 2, and a 3 cross 3 swimming pool. Now if you have a swimming pool which is a 10 cross 10 swimming pool, how would you, how many tiles, boundary tiles, that's the black tiles, will you need? Is the question clear? Is the question clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So Pushottam sir has got an answer. Is there anybody who disagrees with Pushottam sir? Or agrees with him? People are still calculating, I guess.
ma'am.
So Pushottam sir said 44, you are saying 144. 36, you are not supposed to count the 100 in between. Only 36, the borders.
36?
36. 36. So some says 36, some says 44.
38, madam. 38.
38, ma'am. Okay. Are you typing your answers also? Is there every type? 36. Okay, fine. We will come to whether who is correct and who is not correct at the end of it. But how did you solve this?
(10²-8²), ma'am.
You did 10²-8²? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And why did you think the 10²-8² will work?
Observing, ma'am.
Observing. Okay. No problems.
Pattern. In first one, 3²-1², second one, 4²-2², third one, 5²-3².
Yeah. Okay. Great. Okay. So now, so this is, this actually happened in one of my classrooms where I asked this question, and then I went and asked this question now. So, how many tiles for a 75x75 swimming
pool?
296. How did you do it?
75² - 73²
You did 75²
yes.
75 + 73 into 75 - 73.
It is A plus B into A minus B.
Okay. So most people are getting 296. So now we are actually coming to more of a consensus with the 10 cross 10. We had a lot of more problem, like lot of different answers. Now we are coming to a answer that is 296. Can you see the third problem? Thank you.
from 4 and minus 4.
How much is it, sir?
4 into n minus 1.
Do you want to just put your answers in this and see whether it's correct? 4 into n minus 1. Can you just see it in when your n is 1? What is happening?
Yeah, it is 0. It is 0.
But your power is not 0, right?
Ah, that's right.
So it cannot be 4 into n minus 1.
Ma'am, which one you are talking as a tile in this? Actually, is it the white one or?
This is the black one. The tile, the border is the tile, no? The tile, right?
Not inside. Swimming pool is not there.
Madam,
if it is a black one, it is n plus 2 the whole square. If it is a black one. I feel so. Because if it is 1, there are 9 tiles. If it is 2, we are having 16 tiles. We are having plus 2, adding plus 2. If you are having 3, it is 25 tiles. So I feel it is n plus 2 the whole square. Yes, ma'am.
Bindu, ma'am, just can you put it?
Yeah.
They want to say names of one PGT max, one PGT English.
Shriva, sir, you need to mute yourself.
Physics, chemistry, bio.
I feel it is n plus 2 the whole square, because when we are having one tile, we are having 9 black tiles across it. So 1 plus 2, 3 the whole square. When we are having, I think it is like that, maybe.
Just check out for 2, ma'am. N is 2.
Ma'am, it is not 9 black, it is only 8 black. 8 black, please.
Sorry.
You people want to go back and change your answers for 75 plus 75 now?
Ma'am, Aloka, ma'am, it goes with AP 8, 12, 16 and so on. 8, 12, 16 and so on.
Okay. Yeah. So what is the answer? What is the answer for 75 plus 75?
It is 4 into n plus 1. 4 into n plus 1.
4 into n plus 1. Okay.
Yes.
We will come to, sir, why you think so.
Yes. 4 into n plus 1. Yeah.
Okay. So now this is the tile and these are not marked. And these are the answers. Can you see 4n plus 4 is what you said, right, sir?
Yes,
that is correct.
Right now, I'm going to give you some more answers that my children gave, and I want you to see whether they are correct and how did they count it. Okay, so n plus 2 into 2 plus n into 2. N plus 1 into 4.
Yes, I gave.
And 2 into n plus 2 into 2.
Yes.
These are the answers that my children gave me
I asked.
Sir, let me complete my question. Pushottam sir, is that okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Complete my question. Yeah. So what I want you to find out is how did the children come to each of these questions? Like how did the child get n plus 1 into 4, say for example, as the answer? Or how did the child get n plus 2 into 2 plus n into 2? What was the child doing? Is my question clear?
What way they are thinking to get the particular answer? Okay, after simplification.
Right,
you are right.
It's not about simplification. It is about how did they get this answer.
Okay, I got it. Ma'am, shall I take this case? N plus 2 into 2. Pardon? I take this case.
Take one of
them. N plus 2 into 2 plus n plus 2.
Yeah.
When you see this side, if n is there, on both the sides there are 2 tiles. So n plus 2. Like the 2 edges, right. 2. So n plus 2 into 2.
Right.
And this side it is n only. So this is n, right. This is n. So 2n. So right. The chain must have arrived at this answer. So
absolutely
there are 2 n plus 2s. And there are 2 n's, therefore n plus 2 into 2 plus, this is the answer. Okay.
Absolutely correct.
Yeah.
Right. So that's how the child has got.
Yes.
Okay. So now what happened was when I asked the, so if I had stopped at 75 plus 75 or 10 plus 10, is there a problem, sir?
No, no, ma'am. Nothing.
Yeah. So if I had stopped at this problem and not given this problem, then I wouldn't have got all these answers, right? What happened when all these answers came, and it is very interesting, is the discussion as to why are they same? Why are all the four same? They look so different, right? Don't they look different?
Yes, ma'am.
They look different.
They look same, apart from simplification part, but they are all same. They are all...
Yeah, but they look different.
They look different for a child.
And then,
How the answer is reached, that is how the child is thinking that it's different.
Right. And then in our classroom, we had this discussion as to why are they the same? Why are they giving the same answer? And then we had this very different techniques of seeing whether these are the same thing or not. Isn't that what we do about opening brackets and simplification and things like that, right? So this particular problem is actually a situation of where you're learning through the problem. I mean, me as a teacher also learned through this problem when I was actually doing it with children. Do you agree that this is a situation of learning? Yeah.
Excellent situation, ma'am. Fine.
Okay, now I want you to look at this. Now, Manisha ma'am has seen this, I think, because she was in the Vigyan Pratibha program. But anyway, so this is a table, and think of some patterns which hold for all the numbers given in the table. I want you to think of some pattern. Please type it, because all of you will come up with lots of patterns. I know, I'm very sure of that. So it's best that you just type it. I'm looking at I'm looking at the chats. So think of some numbers, some patterns which hold for all the numbers given in the table. Also verify whether your patterns hold for any natural number. And then think if your pattern is true and prove it. So proving it we'll leave, but the other two we can think of doing. Yeah. So is typing very difficult? Then you can talk. I mean, is that typing it can be very problematic in typing, especially if you're on the phone. That's the case, then you can
N square, man.
It's a N square thing. That's right. I have written it's N square. I'm saying, can you see any other pattern?
The difference between the two consecutive terms, it's forming an AP.
Yes. Different in two consecutive. This is 3, this is 5, this is 7. Are you saying that, sir? Or upstairs?
Yeah.
It's forming an AP.
Ma'am, there can be a relation in both the rows as well. For example, the square that is 4 is written, so it is the sum of 1, 1 and 2. And then 9 is the sum of 4, 2 and 3. Like 3 numbers that are around.
Can you see my cursor? So you're saying this is like a ulta L.
Ulta
L thing will give me this.
Them, then that other, yes, this number will come. And it is happening everywhere.
Happening everywhere. That's nice. Can others also see it? What she's saying is that if I look at this L, I add all the 3 numbers in the L, then I will get this number. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Yes, somebody else was talking. Jitendra says square of even is even and square of odd is odd. Perfect. Absolutely correct. Square of even is even and square of odd is odd. That's something that we see in the table. What else?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
If we multiply cross 2 into 9 minus 3 into 4. 2 nines are 18.
Yeah.
18 minus 12.
Yeah.
Is twice of 3.
Wow.
2 threes are 6. 3 sixteens are 48 minus 36. And it is a product of 2 and 3. Actually, 3 into 16 minus 9 into 4. 3 sixteens are 48. 48 minus 36, that is 12. 3 into 4 is 12.
Okay. And why do you think it will always work?
Yes, ma'am.
Why?
4 25s are 100, 16 5s are 80, 100 minus 80 is 20, 4 5s are 20.
The pattern is working.
The pattern seems to be working. Yes. But will it, we are not very sure whether it will always work. But that's fine. I mean, right now, we don't, not even looking at it like that. It's working? Oh, that's nice.
Yes.
Okay. So, fine. So, I will leave that pattern to whatever ma'am said. Ma'am, it would have been nice if you could just type it. Can you just type the number so that it's for all of us, we have that pattern with us? So you're saying, or I can do it for you. So you are saying that you can just, say it. 2 into?
For example, first one, 1, 2, and we are taking the bottom row, 1, 4. 1, 4, so cross, four, means multiplying then? Cross two multiplying.
Yes, this ma'am. Is the one, right? 1 into 4 is minus 2 into 1.
Yes, ma'am.
Is equal to 4 minus 2, which is equal to 2.
It is the product of the number in the top row.
Oh, nice. Okay, fine. So this is a pattern that, what's your name, ma'am?
Lija.
Lija, ma'am, has given us. So, fine. So now, any other pattern somebody wants to give? Am I audible? Yes, Sarmishta ma'am says 2, 3, 7, 8 never occur in the unit space of the square of any number. Correct. Anything else? Everybody is muted, is it? Suddenly? Yes, Subhit sir is giving another pattern.
Yeah. No, madam. What Lisa ma'am has said, no, I have given the general proof of that.
Oh, that's nice, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Welcome, ma'am.
That's perfect. Lisa ma'am, you can have a look at what Subhit sir is saying. But this is I had not come across this particular pattern up till now. So very nice.
Yes, sir. Exactly correct.
Yeah. Okay. So we came up with a lot of patterns, right? I mean, I just gave you a table and you came up with a lot of patterns, right? Isn't this something that we talked about? Like one of the patterns that came was this. It's an AP, right?
Madam, triangular numbers.
These are triangular numbers, but basically 1 plus 3 is equal to 4, 3 plus 6 is equal to 9. So basically like each of them is also a sum of triangular numbers, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did this come up? None of them end with 2, 3, 7, 8. Did it come up?
Yeah.
Yes,
somebody said it. Yes. Yeah, somebody said. I remember Sarmishta ma'am said it. Right? So, if you look at this, I am actually, in these two problems, I'm actually specifically giving you a pattern and telling you to find the pattern. Well, in this, I just gave you a situation and told you to go ahead and do what you want to do with it. Isn't it? Do you see the difference between these two questions? Or there is no difference?
This allows us to think more. The child can think in various ways rather than being specific.
There is an openness to the thought process here, right? Yeah. It's not just open-ended. It's also an openness of thought process. It's a completely open thing. But it is actually an excellent situation of learning because actually, like every time I have shown this table to a new person, I have heard of a new pattern. Like the today what I had heard. Today I heard from Lija ma'am. Right? I mean, it's an amazing situation of learning where you actually are it's just the openness of the task that allows you to do that. Right? Okay. Now, I think, this is a problem that all of you have heard. If 21 by 5 is a multiple of 9, then where y is a digit, what is the value of y?
Yeah, such questions are there in the textbook, class
8.
It can be 1. Can it be anything else?
No, it is 1. No. It is
1. Multiple of 9.
It is 1.
It is 1.
It cannot be anything else. Right? It can be no 1. It is 1. It is 1.
It is only 1.
Okay, now what about this one?
Only one.
Only 1, right. I got that. Second problem, it's already put up.
Okay.
x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 4.
Is that the only answer?
Other answers also. 7, 7,
7. Yes. Seven zero.
That was something which I thought of. Anything else? Anything else? That's it.
No, one minute, madam. Y can be 4 also.
Why 4 is the ma'am said no? Why ma'am said no? 3 and 4?
Yeah, 3 and 4.
4 and 3 can also be
4. No, 4 and 3 we cannot have. Last digit cannot be 3 because it is a multiple correct, of 4. Right.
6 is 4.
Y is 4. No, multiple of 9 and
4. Y is 4.
Okay. 8, 0, 3, 4 and 0, 7. Sorry, 7, 0, 3, 4 and 0, 7.
0, 7?
0, 7 is not possible.
No, sorry.
7, 0 is
not possible. 8 and 8 also? It can be 8 and 8 also?
8 and 8 also.
No, 8 and 8 is not possible.
Not possible by? 8
and 8 is possible.
It is not divisible by 4. 68.
8 and 8 is also possible.
68 is not divisible by 4.
8 and 8 is also possible.
Right. 8 and 8 is possible.
Right, 8 and 8 is also possible. So you have three answers. But did you see what happened? I mean, like what happened between the two problems? What changed? Did you see the discussion we had? Okay, first of all, how did you solve it? How did you go about solving it?
Using the divisibility test.
Using divisibility test, ma'am.
No, that's fine. How? What did you use there? How did you solve
ma'am, it? Trial and error. We started typing numbers on the missing values.
You tried trial and error.
Addition of numbers.
For a number to be a multiple of 9, the sum of digits has to be a multiple of 9.
Right.
And for a number to be a multiple of 4, the two-digit number formed on the extreme right, taking the two digits, right, must be a multiple of 4.
Right.
So the tens place digit is 4. The ones place digit can be 0 or 4 or 8 to be divisible by 4.
Right.
And for the sum of digits of the given number is 11 plus x plus y. So right, it is either 11 plus 7 equal to 18. Or 11 plus how much? Yeah, 16 equal to 27.
Right. So where is the trial and error here?
The value of y.
Where is the trial and error? Where is the trial and error? Who said trial? Somebody said no. We did by trial and error. Where is the trial and error? Was there a trial and error?
Yes, ma'am. I think so. It's a trial and error because when we are putting one value and it is not proving the divisibility for the other number, then we have to change it and we try something else.
So where did you do that?
At that
you point. You were very informed. It has to be 0, 4 or 8. So you put 0, 4 and 8. And
last year, and these persons have chosen.
Are they talking to me or themselves on the phone?
Last year, no 10th number on this.
That's Kumar, sir. Can somebody mute him? Yeah, thank you. So, was it trial and error? Akanksha, ma'am, right?
Yes, ma'am. I think it's trial and error.
How is it trial and error? You knew it was 0, 4 or 8. You only put those, right? You did not say, okay, 0 dalke dekhti hu, fir 1 dalke dekhti hu, fir 2 dalke
dekhti hu. No, ma'am. 0, 4 and 8 at the... are you talking about question number 1 or question number 2?
2.
Yes, ma'am. At the place of y, when we put 0, 4 and 8, we are checking for the divisibility of 4 at that time. But for 9, we have to do something else. So at the place of x, we are going to put number, then add it and see that whether it is like checking for the divisibility of 9
as well. Did you all add all the numbers from 0 to 9 and see whether they were divisible by 9? The total?
No, ma'am. I think here the x is dependent variable and y is independent variable. The value of x depends on the value of y. We have to select y first and then x.
Right, but is it trial and error?
No, but it's not trial and error.
It's not trial and error. It's a very, very informed decision that you are taking, right?
Hello, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes. RP Sinha, sir.
The number is divisible by 4 and 9. Right. So the sum should be 36. That means divisible by 9 and 4 also, or multiple of 36.
Sir, it doesn't have to be adding to 4, right? To be a multiple of 4?
A multiple or 4, last two digits should be divisible by 4, na?
Haan, barabar.
So 36 is divisible by 4 hai, or 9 bhi. So sum agar iska 36 aa raha hai, madam. तब भी हो रहा है, जैसे अब सपोज कीजिए x का वैल्यू आ गया 3, अब y का 4 है, तो ए आ रहा है 23,664, इट इज डिविजिबल बाय 4, और दो सभी को अगर सम करेंगे तो सम ऑफ डिजिट्स विल बी 36.
सर, कैन इट बी 36? कैन 2 3 x 6 y एवर गिव यू द सम टू बी 36? देयर एडिशन 2 प्लस 3 प्लस 6 प्लस 9 प्लस 5. Can it ever be give? No, forget now. Can it ever give us 36? Kabhi bhi 36 de sakta hai kya?
No.
Madam, actually 9.
Never 36, madam. Never 36.
9 multiple of 9 hota hai, lekin humko aana chahiye either 9 or multiple of 9 mein aayega 36 agar aa raha hai total.
RP Sinha sir, मैं आपको पूछ रही हूँ कि 2 plus 3 plus x plus 6 plus y कभी भी 36 आ सकता है क्या? अगर x और y 0 to 9 के बीच में है.
Sir, it has to come between
27. Yeah.
Madam.
Yeah, who is that, Sumit sir?
Yeah, ma'am, actually he makes two things together. Yes. The whole number what would be formed, which is a multiple of 9 and 4, would be multiple of 36, but it is not required that the sum of the digits will be 36. It is not, right? Because it is not possible in this particular case. The sum of digit can't be 36.
That's not the divisibility of 36, that the sum of the year has to be 36. So
no, actually if a number is multiple of 9 and if a number is multiple of 4 also, then it is a multiple of 36.
It has to be a multiple of 36.
But the number as a whole must be a multiple of 36. The sum of digits is not that. It may be less than that.
Absolutely. I got you. Yeah. So did you, the second problem is definitely a better situation of learning than the first problem. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Both of them are situations of learning, but the second one is a better situation of learning because you just look at the conversations we had about it, right? I mean, the first problem, somebody said, yeah, answer hai khatam. One aa gaya khatam, right? We just finished and moved
on. Here we have to think two-dimensionally.
Right, two-dimensionally. Yeah, I mean, two-way in whatever, yeah. Okay, let's, this is a question now. Pallav wanted to buy the following three things. A book for rupees 155, a notebook for rupees 86, and a pen set for rupees 79. What was the total cost of his purchase? Okay, I don't want you to answer this, but I'm saying that this is just an addition problem. But now if I do this, can you see the second problem? The total he got was 248. Clearly he made a mistake. What was the reason for this? He added one of the prices twice. He forgot to include one of the three prices. He left off the last digit in one of the prices and he subtracted one of the prices instead of adding it. Which is the correct answer?
Madam, how many only items, each item, how many he purchased?
One each.
option C.
Just let people think first. Yes. Just give them some time. Let's give each other a lot of some time.
Option C is correct, I think.
So just 2 minutes. Okay. We need to hurry up. I thought that I didn't have any material, but it seems that it was, we have like really gone beyond. So yes, it's option C. What we can do is in today's afternoon session, if you can give me like 15 minutes of your time, we can discuss this further. But I need to, there's at least one problem I want to talk to you about. So who said option C?
I
don't know the name. Sumit sir.
Okay,
Sumit sir, can you tell why the answer is C?
Ma'am, because 155 plus 86 is 241 plus 7 is 248. So definitely he left 9.
But you just randomly like picked up these numbers and got it, or you there was some way you went about with it?
No, straight away I added. I've seen that the sum is more than that. So I just randomly removed 9 from that.
But you did not try for the A option, the B option, no, the C option, D option. You just went to the C option.
Because if someone buying something, I think he added one of the prices twice, ye possibility mujhe lagta nahi hai ki aisa hota hai.
Achha.
Normally people,
while adding, they write
something wrong.
Okay, you went by psychology.
Yeah.
Fine. I went about it in a very different way. What I did was I looked at just the last digits of this and the eighth here, and figured out that what was happening, and then I think I got the C. But anyway, I'm going ahead. We can talk about this problem in the afternoon session. Okay, so this is a pattern. Can people see the pattern? And these are my questions. Okay. What can you see the difference between the first three and the last three problems? Is there any difference between them, and what is the similarity between them? Is the question clear? Is the question clear?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Clear.
Yeah.
Okay. So, what do you say?
The 55th one will be an ellipse, because every fifth figure is a round or an ellipse.
Okay.
94th will be a sun.
Give me one minute. I'm not asking you the answers. I know you know the answers. I'm saying first three and last three. Is there any difference or any similarity between this set of questions?
The last three questions require a generalization.
Right. It requires a generalization. It requires non-counting, right? You cannot count and get it. 55,
yes.
I can do right till 55, or I can figure out some kind of a generalization of a short-term generalization, a local generalization. But the
next... 3 into 18 is 54, and then 55th will be the pentagon.
55th will be a pentagon, sir? Who said
that?
Yeah, it's not a pattern of three. It's a pattern of five.
Pattern of five.
Yeah. Okay. So I have very, very interesting things that have happened in the classroom when one does patterns with children of various age groups. But basically what I wanted to say was, again, if you look at the first three and the last three, which one do you think is a better situation of learning?
Second one, fourth, fifth, and sixth.
Right, because that is a lot of mathematical communication. There's a lot of generalization, but the first three are important to get to the next three. That's also very clear, right? That you need to do also some specifics. You can't just jump to generalization. Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Oh, I hope this is the last question. So if the key, 5 key on your calculator is broken, how would you solve this problem? You have to do 58 into 86 and the 5 is not working in your calculator. You have to use a calculator. So please don't say, haath se kar dunga. Don't say, I'll do it on paper. You have to use the same calculator.
Replace 58 by 60
minus 2.
Can you just type it? That would be easier. Or sure. If it's not, if you're using a computer, please type it. If you are using a mobile phone, 60 minus 2 is 84. Right, I saw it's a bit, sir. Yes, right, perfect. Right. Nice. 29 into 2 into 86. Nice. So what are all of you people using when you're doing this?
Or we can use the distributive method, 60 minus 2. First way.
That's what Sumit sir has done. Very nice, Pushottam sir. So what are all of you doing right now?
Properties of
you're using numbers. Properties of numbers without actually saying it, right? Or without actually saying it. Okay, now this one. It's slightly complicated, but I know you will get it. So that's fine. Yeah. But you see that this particular problem, it's such a huge resource for understanding things, right? Understanding numbers, understanding properties, and it's a fun thing. It's a very good situation of learning. Do you agree with that? You don't have to say it just because I'm asking it. You can say, yeah, I think this is not a good situation of learning. So. That's correct, Sumit sir. So do you think this is a good situation of learning, this problem? Where you talk about a calculator is broken and then you tell them to solve these things.
Yes, of course. Right? Of course.
It is, and it's very open. It's very open. I mean, the answer is correct. Its answer is not open. Answer is specific. You will get 58 into 86, same one. But the different techniques of going it, right? You will have different approaches to do it. Okay. So, I think I'll be able to finish this on time. So, we looked at a lot of problems, right? If there are any particular problems you want me to go back, I will finish this presentation and then I can go back to it. Anybody wants to say something? No, I'll move ahead.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. So now, what was common in all the problems we saw? What do you think was common in all the problems that we saw?
We use the property.
We use properties of what, ma'am?
Distributive property.
That was the last problem. This problem, no?
Yes, ma'am.
I was talking about all the problems that we have seen now. We saw about 10 of them. So what was common in all
the problem solving ability?
They were for problem solving ability.
Always
problem solving by critical thinking, ma'am.
Critical thinking. Okay.
It's not critical thinking. You just made children think in different ways.
Yes, think.
Madam, decomposing each factor as a sum or difference of that should not be there in that. Decomposing each factor.
Sir, we have this is the problem you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
Madam, is it in general you are asking all the questions which
all the problems, all the problems, sir. The 10 problems that we made.
You gave children a wider way to look into the answers, not a specific one way only.
There was an openness, right? Openness of I think what you're saying. There was an openness of answers for sure. There's also an approach.
Approach. I was meaning approach.
Yeah. So not there was just an openness. One specific. Right, there was an openness of answers, but there was also openness of approach, which was very crucial. Concepts. Concepts. So you can choose to use which concept you want to use, right? I mean, for example, if you look at the polar bear problem, you can actually decide which one to use. You don't have to use estimation. You can use data collection and get it, right? So there was an openness of concept. There's not a strictness of using of concepts, right? Each property, each problem was an opportunity to think and construct something new. They were constructing new things in the problem itself. So, like if you see even the one with the dogs feeding versus just the bare number, you see that there is a lot of other possibility of constructing a new meaning of division, which the division, just the bare numbers doesn't give me, right?
Yes.
So it's a relationship. You develop relationship between concepts and between numbers. You have estimations of quantities of different types. And then one, the most important thing, and I think that is, I think all of us completely and totally agree, is mathematical communication. Each of them gives us an opportunity of mathematical communication, right? Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, is do you want me to talk about any of these points in detail more?
No, ma'am, they are clear.
Yeah, clear? Okay. So, basically, what I want to do, I want you to do for your group work is that I want to, like, groups of five teachers, I think. And what I would like you to do is look at five examples from your test books, which can be modified to get these attributes. So, like, basically become better for learning. Is that clear what I'm saying? Hello?
Madam, the group is having 10 teachers.
Okay, whatever. So I thought it was 5, but it's 10. That's fine. So the 10 teachers, find 5 examples. I'm fine with 5 examples because we don't have time for presentations otherwise. You can find more if you want to, but...
Let them have 5 examples and let them present 2, because
there
will be sufficient for that only. The remaining, they can share it in our WhatsApp group so that others can also use it in their workshops.
Yeah, okay.
Please explain once, madam, what you want to explain it again.
So I'll give you an example. If you remember the 21xy question, right? That was, you wanted to go back to that question? This one. Can you see this?
Yes. Yes.
Now the question, the first question is a textbook question.
Yes.
The second one is not a textbook question. Right? I modified the textbook question to make it better. Better situation of learning. Is that okay? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yes, yes, madam.
Okay. So basically something like this. Yeah. So we can also change the presentation a bit and say that if you can actually even look at some 5 problems and analyze them, I'm okay with that also. But modification is fun. I mean, if you can actually look at a problem and say, okay, if I just change this much, then this will happen. It is fun. So you can just do that. I'm going to type my email. I am on that group. So if anybody has any doubts, you want the pattern of perfect squares, I will just come back to that. Yeah, just give me a minute.
Okay. I think they can explore problems from geometry, algebra, mensuration and all, because
they're most of the... Principal sir, is that what you wanted? What I'm screening now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah?
Yes. I'm Dr. M.M. Usmani, Principal KVBSF Jodhpur.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Regarding this question, 23x6y, is it okay?
Let me go back to that. Just 1 minute, sir. There was another principal, sir. Principal Karaikudi has asked me to show the patterns of perfect squares. Sir, are you okay with this now? Must be. Okay. So this question, tell me. Yes, sir. Principal from Jodhpur, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, tell me.
This 23x6y is a multiple of 9 and 4. What are the possible values of x and y?
Yeah.
In the first question, you have mentioned where y is a digit.
Yeah. The second question also, y is a digit. It's because it's coming from the first question, that's why I did not mention it.
Okay. Here also, it is a restriction that x and y both are digits.
Yes, they are digits from 0 to 9. Yeah. Okay. Sorry, I should have completed it. Yeah, I have completed in my files now.
Exactly. But,
yeah. Okay. So is my group work, is the group work clear to people?
Yes, ma'am, it is clear.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. But anyways, my number is in the Google. But I will also type it here because I don't think I have my name typed there. So this is my number. If anybody has any doubts about the presentation, about the group work, you can just message me or call me. I'm absolutely fine with it. And I will just send my presentation right away to the group so that if you want to look at it while doing the thing. Anything else you want me to do or say, or any problems you want to go back to? Any comments you want to make?
Firstly, let us request any principal, those who are attending this, if you have any query, you can ask Aloka madam, please.
Any principal? Even teachers.
First, we will start with principals, the course directors. Okay, then we will move on to teachers, participants. You have any query?
No.
I think in the presentation, if there is a variety of topics, it will be highly nice to take from number theory and go from.
Srinivasa, some teacher, some teacher was, some sir was saying something. Yes, sir.
Rasul?
Yes, sir. Class was live, excellent, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, now I think in the presentation, it will be always nice if you have a variety. But please try to have algebra, geometry, trigonometry and all, so that you have a variety. Here mostly we have algebra and then number theory. Okay, I think any other question to Aloka madam?
Sir, mera ye kehna tha, ye jo paanch teacher hain, wo koi ek hi teacher denge ya koi do denge, ya ek paanch teacher denge?
You decide sir, from your group you just...
Aur dusra kya hai sir, madam ne aaj jo dikhaya, bas मतलब जो प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग में इसे बच्चा सोचना स्टार्ट कर देगा, और यही चीज मुझे हम लोगों का टारगेट यही है कि बच्चा सोचना
टारगेट है. बट यू कैन प्रिपेयर एवरीबॉडी इंडिविजुअली, यू कैन प्रिपेयर क्वेश्चंस.
ओके,
एंड व्हाई प्रेजेंटेशन यू बेटर प्रेजेंट इज अ बेटर टू, एंड द रिमेनिंग यू जस्ट शेयर इट विद अदर्स सो दैट दे कैन यूज इट इन देयर वर्कशॉप्स.
नहीं सुरेंद्र सर, यू हैड अ कमेंट अबाउट द सेशन. आपको सेशन के बारे में कुछ बोलना था ना?
जी हाँ, मेरा ये कहना, ये कॉमन सेशन जो मैंने देखा कि बस उसके बाद ये है कि अगर इस तरह से बच्चों को बताया जाए तो बच्चा सोचना स्टार्ट कर देगा, जो लेजी भी है वो भी सोचना स्टार्ट कर देगा, और हमारा टारगेट ही यही है.
ओके सर, ओके, नाइस थैंक यू सर. आई थिंक इज देयर एनी अदर क्वेश्चन? एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, टीचर्स, प्लीज स्टे बैक फॉर ऑनलाइन अटेंडेंस. Okay, Aloka madam, anything you want to tell? I think we will meet at 4:30 then.
Yeah, I have given my number in the chat. If anybody has any doubts, please feel free to write to me, and I will write. And I've already sent the presentation on the group.
Okay. Now in the evening, they will be presenting in order. Every ZED will be presenting. There will be 5 presentations with 2 questions each. Therefore, we will have a total 10, and the remaining they will share among themselves so that they can use it in their workshop and share it with the workshop who are attending. That will be fine.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you all teachers. It was a pleasure to interact with you. Thank you very much. And I'll see you at
the director and all principals and all the participants. Thank you very much, madam. We'll meet at 4:30 p.m.
4:30 is it? Okay, 4:30. Fine.
Okay, the teachers, please give the attendance now.
Link bheji sir.
अरे भाई, वेट करो 2 मिनट.